today I'm glazing, and I'm glazing these vases, and I'm doing a different kind of glazing for these vases. These are an inlaid fern leaves, and painted it with glazes. And so I'm first glazing it with I'm glazing over the leaf with a clear glaze, and then I'm going to wax it, and then I'm going to glaze it, the rest of the vase inside and out with a white glaze. So first I'm glazing a clear glaze over the leaf and the flower, and then I'll have to carefully wax it, which is very tedious work because we don't want the wax to get in the wrong place, because then it will the glaze will not be able to adhere to the it will resist the glaze. So it's very tedious, but that's the way I decided to do it. I could have also used a transparent glaze over it, but the only transparent glaze I have is Celadon. And I'm not sure I wanted to use Celadon on these vases, so I'm trying this white for the first time in this way. I've used white glaze before, but not in this way. Hope it shows up, I'm not sure. The reason I put a clear glaze over it is so that I've tried before not putting a glaze over it, just having the painting it with the painting glazes, but I didn't like the effect. It was very dull. I didn't like the effect. I needed the glazed effect. Well, the shiny effect, a little shine from the glaze. The clear glaze gives me the effect that I want. In other words. So that's why I use the clear glaze. And then I need to wax it. Because if I don't wax it, then when I glaze it with the white, it would be covered. If I could carefully add the white without, I would, but as a matter of fact, maybe I could. I'll see. Could add the white without waxing it. No, but I think because then the white would be very difficult not to have some white covering the area that I don't want to cover. So I drew the ferns and this, and this is a flower from a hosta that I'm trying to interpret. And the fern. Okay, here is one that I did the same thing. I drew it, painted it, and then I put the clear over it, over the picture, and then glazed it. Then waxed it and then glazed it. And this glaze is can't figure it out more. And here's another one that I did that way. I like the effect. I have to be very careful though when applying the wax. This is another one that I did. The same method. did. This is another one. This is a different plant. I like that plant, which I did the same way. I don't know, plate. Covering it with clear glaze, and then I'll wax it before. I glaze it with white. Chino is a glaze I'm thinking of. Sorry. Yeah, so I after the vase I just showed you, or the pot I just showed you, and the mug, the pots I showed you, those were glazed with, which I did the same method. I first painted the picture, and then I glazed it with clear, the picture, and then I waxed the picture, and then I glazed it with, that's a wax resist, so that it resists the glaze, the next application of glaze. Then I glazed it with Chino. The whole jug, the jugs and the mug. I glazed them with Chino. I hope I like this one first time. I'm doing this design this way. So let's see what happens.
Yeah.